Welcome to video 30 on flight sim navigation. We are still working on our radio and autopilot project, and this video is about how to tune the ADF radio over here. Well, first of all, the panel is finished. There was a previous video on it, and I just thought it funny to compare the original 3D computer design made in Fusion 360 with the definitive real-life version. And besides the color of the spray paint, they look astonishingly similar. I just thought that funny. Well, let's have a look at today's challenge. Here is the ADF radio, and here is the encoder which I would like to use to tune that radio. But there are three digits over here, so what we need to accomplish in MobiFlight configuration is when I press the built-in push button in that encoder, then I change those digits, and when I rotate the encoder, then we change the value of the current selected digit. And then I would like to add one more fun thing. I just invented that yesterday. Why not also tune the ADF dial, the heading, with a next press of that same encoder, and use that same encoder to do that. Then you have you first tune the hundreds, then you tune the tens, then you tune the ones, and then you tune this dial, so you have a complete control over your ADF. Well, let's have a look. Here the MobiFlight app is opened, and I loaded the complete file for the panel. We moved away from our breadboard test situation. And when I'm finished with this file and it's all to my liking, I will publish it as a free download, so anyone who likes to tinker with it can do that. But it's not really 100% finished yet. But anyhow, what we need to do to create this ADF encoder is go to the menu Extras and then Settings, and first we have to add the encoder as a hardware device. Let's find the MobiFlight module that we are working with, which is our Arduino Mega. And here I have added two things that we need. This is the encoder ADF. With me it was connected to pin 17 and 16, and the type of encoder that I am using right now needs to be set to this one detent per cycle, 1-1. But there are, as you can see, five types of decoders, and if your decoder does not work, all you can do is trial and error, try all of these, and one of them should work. If not, then you are unlucky. Then of course we gave it a name, in this case just simply encoder ADF. I did exactly the same for the encoder switch. Oh, did I close that window? Yes, I did. Why did I do that? Let me open it again. I did exactly the same with the encoder switch. It is on pin 18, and the name I gave it is encoder ADF switch, so I can easily find it back later in the software programming. So now we are done with the hardware. We have attached the encoder and the switch to three pins, and we told MobiFlight that they are there. Then of course upload this new software. When you just added these things, you need to upload it to your Arduino, and it's always also a good thing to save the file on disk for later use if something went wrong. Right, let's close this window and let's have a look now at our inputs. We have to tell MobiFlight what function we want it to do when we rotate the encoder. And in this case, there are four functions that I like to happen. Depending on in which state we are with the push button, which comes later, we want to tune the ADF ones or the ADF tens or the ADF hundreds or the ADF heading. So if you don't have those and you need to make them, then simply scroll to the bottom of the column and there you find the double click to add a new config. So I double click and then I add ADF1 and as a name, yeah, and then in the edit button we go to the input and there we select what we want to happen. We select our Arduino module and then we select the hardware encoder that we just made, and then on rotating left, there we go to the event ID. We have to select that from this drop down. And then in this drop down, we have to select one of the operations. And in this case, it is the ADF one decrement. If I rotate left, I want it to decrement. So that is what we do to select it, and then we go to the right tab, and then of course we select the ADF1 increment. Don't forget to press the use button both of the times, because only after pressing use it fills in these important event ID numbers and then it works, else it doesn't. Well, that was it for the ADF1, and of course for the ADF 10, the middle digit, we do exactly the same, but now out of that long list of activities we select the ADF 10 decrement, and on rotating right the ADF 10 increment, and don't forget to press use. For the hundreds we do exactly the same. Then another press, a next press of the button, which we are still going to program in a minute. The next press of the button will shift our function to ADF heading over here, and that is the event ID ADF card decrement. Yeah, it's rotating that dial, that's called the card with the numbers on. And on right, or we do the ADF card increment, and that makes that ADF dial card rotate. Don't forget to press use as ever. Okay, so now we have these four functions over here, and all we need to do now is to distinguish between those four functions by pressing that encoder push button. And to do that, we already had in the hardware had created that push button, but now we are going to use it. Scroll down a bit. What I did is create a encoder switch ADF1100 heading selector. And the memory location that I use is 66C1. And where did I make that memory location? Well, here in the edit. Of course, we select the Arduino again, then we select, now in this case, the encoder ADF switch, so that's the hardware button that we are going to use. This time over here we select the FSUIPC offset, because we are going to create a memory location and load a number in it. The memory location that I use is 66C1. That is one of the available for users empty memories, but we are not going to leave it empty. We are going to set a value in there, and that value is this function over here. Read with me. If the current value is 3, then we make it 0, else we make it the current value plus 1. What this means is, at the startup, the value is 0, so when I rotate that button, I want to tune the hundreds. When I press once, then it jumps from 0 to 1, and then I am tuning the tens. When I press again, my memory location goes from 1 to 2, and I want to tune the single digits. And then when I press again, the memory location goes from 2 to 3, and I can tune that card dial, heading dial. And then when I press again, it goes from 3 to 0. That's the use of this memory location. So this is okay, but now we need to do something else. We need to create an output. So let's go to the output tab over here now, and there we will see that I created a memory toggle ADF 100 and heading. It's just a name, you can give it any name you like. And in the edit I did the following. I skipped this one, I directly typed in that memory location that we were going to use, 66C1. And that's it, we don't have to do anything else. So we can cancel out of here again. This is the output that we now created, that is looking at the value in 66C1. And this is the output that we are now going to use to change those four functions. So let's go back to the inputs again and select our ADF encoder. Where is it? Here, ADF encoder 1. Well, I want to start with the hundreds because that's the first digit I want to tune, and I want to do that at startup. So if the value in that memory relocated is 0, let's go to the precondition tab. I added a condition over here. I selected a config item from this drop-down list. And which one? Well, we can select all the available ones, but this is the memory toggle ADF 1100 heading. Of course, that's the one I'm going to use now. And I want to tune the hundreds of the ADF if the current value is 0. Don't forget to press apply and then OK, and then we have done this one. Then we go to the tens, and the precondition in the tens is that that same value is now 1. When we press the button, it went from 0 to 1, and now we are using this function because this value is 1. And to no surprise, we want to tune the single digits if that value is 2. One more press and that value goes to 3, and that was when we wanted to tune that heading card. So here it is, if that value is 3, we are going to tune that heading card. Don't forget to press apply and then OK. So now we have done everything we need. We created the hardware encoder and push button. Then we created four functions over here for the encoder. And we also created one function over here for the push button. That was the fill the memory location with 0, 1, 2 or 3. And then we created an output to read out that memory location, and that output we used in the preconditions of these four functions over here. That was a mouthful. Let's put it to the test. Okay, so here we have FSX running. In future, I of course hope this to become Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020, if all these extra apps are going to work there. Let's press run for MobiFlight, and still active, yeah, that's okay. We have here the ADF, and of course we also have here now the ADF, and if I rotate this button I should be tuning the tens. Well, that is happening. 4, 3, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to put it on 397, which is my airport, Eindhoven. So one click should me bring to the tens. Yes, I'm going to put that on 9. And another click should be tuning the digits, and that should be 7. And now we should be able to see this needle, yeah, there it goes, point to the airport where I am in the vicinity right now. Well, that seemed to work, but now the proof of the pudding. If I press again, I should press first, of course. If I press again, I will be able to rotate this dial. Yes, I am. Look, can you see that? That dial is moving when I rotate this button. Isn't that great? So with four presses of a button, we can tune everything related to the ADF. Well, this was it. In next video, I think we are going to do the coarse encoder over here.